Oh, hi. Welcome to Working with Dramatic Lighting. So glad you could join me today. I'm your host, clinician Tom Senna. I'm just putting out some materials that we're going to use to work on this technique called Chiaroscuro. While I'm doing that, why don't we take a look at the artist who's put his mark on this famous technique, Michelangelo Merisi, or, as history has come to know, Caravaggio.
In 1595, after many years as an apprentice, a local art dealer, Maestro Valentino, showed Caravaggio's work to Cardinal Francesco Del Monte, an influential member of the papal court. Del Monte would move Caravaggio into his papal palace, making him a member of his salon. Caravaggio would soon go on to sell paintings to many members of the papal court with Del Monte's help. Despite Caravaggio's influential friends, he was often in trouble, forced to flee Rome, first in 1605 for stabbing a man, then again in 1606 after killing a friend in a sword fight. He settled for a time in Naples, often getting involved in minor altercations before ending up in Malta. There, he was received as a renowned artist and was inducted into the Knights of Malta before being expelled from the order when his criminal past was exposed. After being exiled to Sicily for a short time, he again returned to Naples in 1609, but was severely wounded in yet another brawl. After a brief convalescence, Caravaggio set off by boat for Rome in July of 1610. He was arrested on the boat after a stop en route to Rome, but was released on word that his pardon would be approved. The boat, with all of his possessions except a few rolled-up paintings in his hand baggage, left without him. He set off overland to meet it on the Tuscan coast. There, exhausted and suffering from pneumonia and malarial fever, he died on the beach 3 days before his official pardon finally arrived. He was 39 years old.
First thing we're going to need are our supplies. Drawing paper, compressed charcoal, and white erasers. Once we have that, pretty much set to go. Make sure that you have your kids adequately set up around your still life so that they can see from all angles. Ladies, we have everything that we need?
Yep.
Okay, we're pretty much ready to go. For your still life, your object should either be white, off-white, or maybe even beige. Because remember, we're working with charcoal, which is a black and white medium. So your object should be able to reflect the light accordingly, which brings us to the light in itself. Something just like that.
Next, have your students put down the base of the compressed charcoal as dark as possible. Encourage them to smooth it out so that they can get it as black and smooth as they can.
With this process, we're actually going to be doing something called deductive drawing, which means we're taking away the charcoal from the paper, as opposed to a technique like additive drawing, which would be white paper with adding pencil on top. So the students are going to have to start thinking a little bit differently. This time, instead of adding the dark areas of a drawing first, they're going to actually take those erasers and erase away the highlights and work from the lightest point back towards the darkest point. Like every other teenage art student, they're going to be concerned with making mistakes and how to correct them. The mistakes and the corrections are just as easy as if they were doing additive drawing. In this case, now they would have to go back in with the charcoal again and recover the area that they consider to be the mistake and start over.
Once your students begin to master the material and technique, the results should take shape rather quickly.
So that's pretty much the whole technique. At the end of the project, if you want, you can probably have the kids spray them with fixative so that the charcoal doesn't run all over the place. But other than that, that's all there is to it, folks. Thanks so much for coming out and spending some time and learning about some fascinating techniques. Hope to join you again next time. Thank you.